list of parades, so you don't get to get the parade info until later. This one is a poem. So I'll always come back to it. Is a poem called "I'm Not Sick, But I'm Not Well." And forgive me if I say something that's not bad, so that's a nice word, but it's just great. Not bad. I'm not sick, but I'm not well. And I'm sure there's something I can do about this. I've popped the aspirin, the Tylenol, the ibuprofen, the codeine, the Prozac, the sleeping pills, and that thermometer is down my throat, and I'm gagging. I'm not sick, but I'm not well. The doctors find nothing wrong with me, and believe me, they've taken the x-rays. They've stripped me down, maybe wear one of those god-awful paper robes.
Hello?
And they've felt me up, and they've checked me out. They found out what they were looking for, but didn't find anything I was looking for. I'm not sick, but I'm not well, and I can't help but think that everything I'm doing to make things better might only be making things worse. So I don't want to listen to what you have to say anymore, and I want this IV out of my arm, and I want this oxygen tube out from my nose, and I want this suppository out of my ass, and I want you to get that scalpel away from me, because I want everything I've got. I'm not sick, but I'm not well. And they want me if they can keep me in line. And they want me if they can cut me open and take out my insides and suck out the fat and suck out the life and make me generic and make me dependent and make me unreal, make me not whole. And I've walked that line with all of you doctors. And I want all my parts back. And I want to be healthy. No, I'm not sick. And maybe I'm not well. But you're only making me worse. I don't have the answers, but neither do you.
Yeah.
So instead of tearing me apart and dissecting me and studying the bones, let me just stay together for a while until I figure it all out.
Yeah.
And it actually appears in this book. So I would like to share this song with you. John, you're awesome. And he tells me to move over. Yes, sir. And it's called "What We Need in Life." He's looking at the one that you've done wrong. It's called "What We Need in Life." To say
Nothing, yeah. Nothing changes, nothing stays the same. So you go your way and I'll go mine. Maybe one day we will find what we need in life. What we need in life.
But this last one mentions a parade. This is called People's Lives Are at Stake. I know everyone was talking about it, and after the fact, you'd hear reports on the news about the damage done, and you'd think that we were in a war zone, and that all of this was done for religious purposes, and people's lives were at stake. And maybe they were, and I just don't know it. I don't know. I know what it's like to have a cause, but I've never tried to close people out to it. I tried to include them, to open them up to it. But I remember deciding once to walk to a woman's parade called Take Back the Night, so that people knew that women should feel safe walking alone in the streets at night without worrying about being mugged or raped or killed because they were female. Well, anyway, I was walking to this parade to take photographs because I'm a photographer, and a group of women were walking in a group to the parade. So I walked down the street and I started walking with them, and they were chanting and singing, and I thought, wow, this is unity, people together for a cause. And one of the women told me while we were walking that some of the women there didn't like me walking with them because I was white. And they were African American. And so I looked around and I noticed that there wasn't a racial mix. And I said, well, we're all going to the same place. And the woman replied, well, some people don't like you walking along with us anyway. So I turned my head and I let them walk. And I crossed the street and took another block and got there before them. And this is how we define how we should be separated, I suppose, though I still don't understand it. And during that parade, I heard about a trial case where a black man was convicted of a police brutality crime. And the black community was outraged, saying that a white man was holding them down, and maybe they were right, and I just don't understand it. A large group of people then started their own rally that night, which seemed to take center stage over women's rights. I mean, they're just women. What are they going to do? Bitch a little louder or complain a little bit more? But then again, maybe it's just a matter of deciding who has the loudest voice or who has the most recent problem to complain about. I don't know. We went out that night, and I heard the next day that in light of the trial, 23 fires were started on school property. Most of them were of books in libraries. And I thought, this isn't non-resistant violence. This is outright violent. And what they're destroying are opportunities for learning and not ideas. Yeah, but do these books tell us what the white man wants us to learn? Is this how he alters our perceptions? I don't know, but this doesn't solve anything. And this isn't the answer. Then I heard about one of my best friends, a white man, who was hit once by a black man in the street while they were out that night. And the doctor said that he had to have a roll of quarters in his hand or brass knuckles because it was a clean break of his jaw and it was wired then for 6 weeks so that he was stuck throwing pizzas and meatloaf into a blender so he could eat something instead of ice cream. Well, he was doing this while I tried to recover and I thought, is this getting anything done? Are we coming any closer to racial harmony? What are we learning from this? Coming up, my darling. Get that for you.